Welcome to the podcast. You are trapped in history with Mr. Malcomson and Mrs. Basham. This is episode 3. This is going to be a little bit about me and my background. And I know that episode 2 is a little bit about Mrs. Basham because throughout the year, students on both of our classes will get to know a little bit more about us. So just for a little bit about me before I show the little slideshow, this is my 12th year of teaching, and it's also my 12th year at Logan County High School. Many of you have heard of me before. Either you've had friends or relatives that have had me, and hopefully it's not too many horror stories, but I do care a lot about my students, and I pride myself on trying to teach students more about how to think and not and making teaching a little bit more unorthodox before. So it might take a little bit to get used to my teaching style. As many of you have probably experienced, if you started on your first assignment, Mrs. Basham and I have asked you pretty difficult questions about yourself and about your background. And I get that it is difficult because for most of you, it's probably the first time you've ever been really asked stuff like that. But it's only fair that Mrs. Basham and I give you a little bit of background about us too, so that way you can kind of know a little bit more. And as we go through the year and we have more discussions, you're going to find out a little bit more about both of us. So to start off here, I'm going to share the screen and just get to this particular kind of PowerPoint screen. I didn't know really where to start at, so I just found like the earliest picture of myself I could actually find. Many people at the school know, and many of you probably don't know, that I am an identical twin. So I have an identical twin brother named Ben, and I am the one on the left side here. Depending on how you're watching this, you can barely see the white letters on my little t-shirt there. I look like I'm probably already talking and have diarrhea of the mouth again. And my twin brother looks like he's probably saying shut up the whole time. But just to skip ahead all the way to present day, this is someone that's really close to me. So this is my twin brother, Ben. As you can tell, we are twins, but we still look a little bit different. And we're both really tall and a little bit chubby. So, you know, I'm about 6'7", 6'8", about 230 or 40 pounds. We've always been really tall. My twin brother and I, we grew up in southern Indiana. So, yes, both of us are Hoosiers. And I know that for many of you, you're probably just going to throw up right now just even thinking about Indiana Hoosiers if you're a sports fan. I assume that most of you grew up in Kentucky, and if you like sports like we do, you probably like Kentucky or Tennessee or Louisville, and I completely get that. Indiana looks geographically a lot like Kentucky, but you know, just like in Indiana or just like in Kentucky, whenever you grow up, you're kind of assimilated into sports, and that's kind of tied in there because of our father. Other than my twin brother, I have an older brother too, so Ben and I have a 11-year older brother named John. This is where, within the last year, it's been a little bit difficult on my family life and whatnot. Our older brother last year had a stroke at the age of 47, and he's been in a nursing home ever since. And you may hear me talk a little bit about him every once in a while. I know that in your life questions, Mrs. Basham and I asked you a little bit about suffering, and it's one of those things where that's difficult to be closer to your older brother, but it's harder for him to communicate than it was in the past. He's one of the strongest people I know, and he's constantly fighting to get better. But like I said, my twin brother and I are really, really close. Family is extremely important to me. I'm 36 years old now. I do like to travel, and I like to play video games and watch movies and hang out with people. I'm very extroverted, very social, if you can't already tell by the way my personality actually is. But my family is very important to me. So our father passed away whenever Ben and I were 20, and he had cancer. Many of you have also probably been stricken with cancer within your families. So you may know what it's like to experience that or to even unfortunately lose a family member through that. So we were all really, really close with our mother. So I'll get to her here in a little bit too. Now, just to start a little bit of a dog war with Mrs. Basham, I'm going to show, I don't have Basset Hounds like she has. I love Basset Hounds, but I have something even better than a Basset Hound. I have a Boxer Pit, and he is a jerk, grade A jerk. But he's actually really cool most of the time. For some reason, most of my pictures are of him sleeping because I think it's funny looking. He is gigantic. He's about 110 pounds. He is 7 years old. His name, like I said, is Walter. About 7 years ago, that TV show called Breaking Bad was really popular, and the main character was Walter. So I liked Walter because it also kind of sounded like an old man. And he kind of is my little old man guy. So I live in Lewisburg. You know, this basically is my son. I don't have my own kids. I don't have anything against children or anything like that. But like many of you, though, I'm also like a big fan of having pets and whatnot. So my favorite picture is the one at the top left. I wish I could make that my my thumbnail picture. I might have to do that for the podcast just because that's probably my favorite one. And as you can see, when he sleeps, he will find awkward ways of laying around, and his giant Laffy Taffy tongue hangs out of his mouth all the time. Or sometimes he'll just stare at me like this, and I'm just wondering what he's thinking. But yeah, this is Walter. And just this last year, Walter gained a little sister. So this is Ellie. Ellie is named after the video game The Last of Us and the female character on that game. As you can see, Ellie is much smaller. I think she is like a, I can't remember what kind of dog. I think she's kind of a Chihuahua, Jack Russell Terrier mix. She has a little underbite problem where her teeth hang out all the time. But as you can tell, she's like basically Walter's little buddy, and he looks after her a lot. And this is one of my favorite pictures of them just looking out the door sometime there in the winter time. But like I said, animals are a big part of my life. I care a lot about animal protection and whatnot. And as we go through the year, it'd be kind of cool to see if some of you are also dog lovers, because you can tell that Mrs. Basham and I are both big fans of that. So I don't know if Walter really competes with her two, basset hounds, but nonetheless, pretty cool dog, a big part of my life. This is my last part of the slideshow to finish up. At the bottom left, like I said, that is Ben and I's, and John, or this is our mom. My mom just turned 74. My mom is a huge influence on my life because she's also very opinionated and she's very involved. I'll never forget growing up, she took care of a lot of elderly people and would take them going grocery shopping and help them clean their house. And I remember just growing up and seeing her help people. I wanted to do a career where I could help other people and influence them. I would not be a teacher if it wasn't for my mother. My mother's a rock. She's like the strongest female that I know in my entire life. Moving over at the top, there is like the Indiana Hoosiers basketball court. Like I said, I have that because, like I said, it's really gotten me and my twin brother have been able to get so much closer the last 3 years doing this podcast that covers the university. We've had this awesome chance of talking to so many student athletes and making connections with people, and that's been really fun. At the bottom right is me and Ben with our two nephews. This is my oldest nephew, Jacob, and he's a police officer. I highly respect him. Just recently got married and found out that he's going to be a father. So I'm going to be a great uncle, and I'm really excited about that. Our youngest nephew, this is Caleb. So he had just graduated just a couple of years ago. He is just now starting to go to Indiana University. He's also going to be a teacher with German as we go forward. So it's really exciting for that. A little bit of just kind of quirkier things. Some people have favorite holidays. I'm a huge fan of like scary movies and scary games and things like that. So I'm a big fan of Halloween. I've always been really involved in that. And several years ago, we had put together like this little party thing where we had people come over for Halloween and we had like this little decoration. So just to kind of illustrate how weird we are, but also we're really into Halloween. And it's kind of cool to know if some of you are like that as well. Other than that, if I go back to before I was a teacher, that was like 13 years ago before, I try to think back on all these weird jobs that I did. And believe it or not, for about 3 years, I was a butcher. So I don't know if you can picture me dangerously using knives and making steaks and whatnot, but I did that for a while because that helps to make money while you're going through college. As some of you will probably find out as you go through school and you try to work before you get a career going and whatnot. I also worked for IGA, like the grocery store business, for 7 years as a manager with them before teaching. It's a great company to work for, to go through school for that. At the top right, you can see my last time that I ever did stand-up comedy. So I'm a kind of a failed comedian. I used to do the little stand-up mic nights. I've always just enjoyed joking around, making people laugh. I will probably use a lot of humor throughout the year, and it'll probably be failed most of the time. So you can just make me laugh a little bit, make me feel a little bit better, to humor myself into that. But I did enjoy doing that kind of experience for a while, and I like sharing some of those stories as well. So the last part of this podcast, of episode 3, is this part at the bottom. So over the last couple of years, especially during this quarantine part, is that I've gotten a lot more into podcasting. And a couple of years ago, my brother asked me to be on this sports podcast called Hoosier Heartland. We interviewed, like I said, lots of student athletes and whatnot. And man, it's really opened my eyes up to what people go through in their lives. And just to kind of connect something to make you all feel a little bit better, because you're also going to have to get used to talking to people over a camera again and getting used to doing school in a different way. The woman that's in the middle of this picture down here is Kathy Chung. She joined our podcast in March. I have never met her in person, but since March, she's been on this podcast every week. She's one of the best friends I have And I really feel like I know her and I've known her my whole life. And it's cool to see, like, yes, over social media, over a webcam and doing interviews, you can really get connected to people. And that's something that means a lot to Mrs. Basham and I as teachers. Our teaching style, we prefer being in person. Like, most of the time when you walk in our classroom, if you walk in mine, at least with the desk, it looks a little bit more like a group therapy meeting more than it looks like a regular class, because I rely on you to learn the content, but to also sit and make it relate to your personal life and actually be able to debate with each other, to logically and intelligently argue things out, make points, become more open-minded and help you think a little bit better. And that's what our goal is to do this year, is really just to make you think. And I think that we can do that, but I just need you to buy in. I need you, when you get into that class, we need you to be able to really kind of get into what we're doing, because the learning can be much more fun that way, and it can be much more engaging with the whole process. And you're not just doing multiple choice questions or, you know, Google Doc assignments. I'm giving you a chance to voice your opinion, use it, like, you know, really garner that ability to be able to argue in an intelligent way as we go forward. So I enjoy that podcast. Below that, with my ugly head in front of the broken light bulb, I started a philosophy podcast a couple of years ago. You know, philosophy is part of history, part of humanities. And all that word means is a love of knowledge. And I named this podcast after Socrates. And I have former students on all the time. I have friends. I have philosophers and historians and other people come on. And we discuss really big topics like love and hate and violence and movies and sports and just basically all these open topics. And maybe, who knows, someday after you graduate, maybe you want to be on a show, one of those shows with me. So I'm a little bit more annoying when it comes to doing these meetings and these podcasts, because I've been doing them for about 3 years and I really enjoy the process. And that's pretty much it. As I go through the whole process here, I really hope that you like some of the things that I've shared. I know it's not nearly as detailed as the life questions that I've given you, but just keep in mind that as I stop the share screen, keep in mind that those life questions are important to us because they give us a little bit more feedback about who you are and the way you think and what you like and what you don't like. These things are extremely important. And you may be thinking, how is this life questions package social studies? It's everything about it is social studies. I think you have to truly understand yourself more before you can start taking a deep dive into the lives of other people and to other civilizations, because it's going to make a difference. And I hope, my goal is that when you guys graduate in 2 years and you look back 5 or 10 years or more from now, is that I don't want you to regret having me as a teacher or Mrs. Basham or any of your teachers at Logan County. I want you to look back on that experience and be glad that you had that. And you feel like it actually got you ready for the real world. And that's what I'm here for, is that, yeah, these assignments are not going to be easy all the time. And these conversations won't be easy all the time. And sometimes your head's going to hurt with the stuff that we're going to discuss. And that's okay, because you're learning and you're growing through that process. And I enjoy, you know, that dialogue back and forth and the devil's advocating back and forth as we have discussions. So other than that, that's a little bit about me. I hope that you've enjoyed episode 3 of the podcast. I hope that you like Walter better than Mrs. Basham's dogs. But nonetheless, just be an awesome animal pet lover. It's great. It's a great experience. Other than that, I hope all of you have a great night.